2013 has started just like last year ended, with big jobs losses, leaving many Sydney families in turmoil. 1,000 were axed today at two big Australian companies. Danielle Isdale joins us now from our Tarmon. And Danny, some big cracks have appeared at one of our biggest concrete makers.
That's right, Tash. Boral's new boss, they started last September. His first order of business was to conduct a review. And this is the result of it, that the company is burdened by excessive overhead costs. In the good times, they were less obvious. But now that times are tough in the construction industry, those costs have become critically exposed.
Boral's slogan is build something great. Now the company is pulling itself apart, announcing 700 jobs will go.
Nobody wants to see job losses. Our first thoughts are with any of the affected workers.
With Qantas, Telstra, ANZ, Toyota and Rio Tinto among dozens of big companies shedding positions last year, BlueScope Steel announced redundancies this week, and today Crazy John's hung up. Vodafone will take over its stores and clients from next month, but not all will remain open, so 300 jobs are at risk.
Crazy Giants have always been that loyal brand. There's that logo, that's a great story behind it.
A story that's now over, though some customers don't care which brand is on their bill.
Forget the cheapest deals, get the cheapest deals.
Boral's CEO insists customers won't be affected, and the job cuts apply to mostly managerial and office support staff. But the union is very concerned operational employees will find themselves in the firing line too.
And frankly, the company has mismanaged the way they've done this announcement, because there are workers right across the country trying to clarify whether they are in the line or not.
Economists are optimistic.
Unemployment is actually at low levels. I think in 2013, with that better growth prospect, we'll actually turn the corner.
And more will get jobs instead of lose them.
The rosiest view of all this is that the 2012 job losses were all part of the consequences of the global financial crisis, and that cycle is now over, so that 2013, with predicted growth, should look a lot brighter in terms of the job situation. Tash?
Let's hope so. Thank you, Danny, reporting there.